In this lesson, we're going to create a new super user and our database for our application on our server. Just like we did with our Vagrant server, we need to create a super user if we want to log in to the application. So make sure that you're logged in to the server using SSH, and then type sudo hyphen I. Sudo hyphen I changes us to the root user on the server. So we're logged in as the super user of the Ubuntu operating system, the root user. Next, we're going to work on the virtual environment that we created for our server. So we need to type the path of our virtual environment and activate it. Type source /usr/local/virtualenvs/profiles_api/bin/activate. We didn't have to type this on our Vagrant server because we used a tool called virtual mwrapper. Virtual mwrapper does all this stuff for you, but it's not always great to install that on a production server because a production server is it's a tool that's used to help the developer switch between virtual environments. And typically, you wouldn't need that on a live production server and it would just kind of be an extra dependency. So that's why we don't install the virtual mwrapper on our server. All right, so make sure you've got the URL typed here. I've also put it in the resources of this video, just in case you want to copy and paste it in, and then hit enter. You can see that just like on our virtual, on our local Vagrant box, it changes us to the virtual environment that we have activated. Okay, so now let's switch to the location of our project, which is cd/usr/local/apps/profiles REST API. And then from this directory, let's move into the /src and then the profiles_project. All right, now we can use the manage.py command to create our database. So let's go ahead and type python manage.py migrate and hit enter. You can see that it goes ahead and runs our migrations. So this will create our new SQLite database and it will set up all the tables that we defined in our migrations. All right, next let's create a super user. So type python manage.py create super user, hit enter. I'm going to give it the user mark@londonappdeveloper.com. Of course, you can use your own email address for this. And then in the name, I'm going to type my name, Mark Winterbottom. And then in the password, I'm going to type my favorite test password of awesome1 with a capital A. Hit enter and then re-enter that password. And now it's gone ahead and created our super user. Okay, great. So now that we have a database and a super user, we can move on to the next lesson. Thank you so much for watching. I hope you found this useful and I'll see you in the next lesson.